of you. Today I have planned a lecture on geology and soil mechanics on the topic of mineralogy. Previous to my earlier lecture that I had given on I had given the lecture on the topic of geology, how I had defined and branches of geology and importance of geology to civil engineering works. We had covered in the earlier lecture. So today's lecture, I would just like to discuss on mineralogy. So in mineralogy, when we talk about mineralogy, we can just begin how important minerals are, and as a part of this chapter on mineralogy, I would just like to cover. I'd just like to cover this, and I will just define what is mineralogy. Basically, as it is so clear that mineralogy is the study of minerals. So mineralogy is a study of minerals. Now, this is being a part of geology and soil mechanics. Being a part of this geology and soil mechanics, as we know, so when we talk about geology and soil mechanics, this is the study of rocks. This is geology and soil mechanics is the study of rocks. And rocks are of various categories, as we had covered in the earlier lecture. Today in mineralogy, how important mineralogy is, because mineralogy drives the economy of any country. And a country which is rich in minerals will always be a rich country, because mineral has a very important value. So mineralogy, when we talk about it is very very important for the economic development of a country. So for economic development of a country, it is very very important. When we talk about mineralogy, so mineral is defined as the inorganic substance. So it is defined as inorganic substance. So it is defined as inorganic substance. Inorganic substance found in nature. So inorganic substance found in nature, and where it is found? It is found in the rocks masses naturally occurring in the earth. तो देखिए, हमारा जो अर्थ क्रस्ट है, इट इज बेसिकली डिवाइडेड इनटू वेरियस लेयर्स, बट व्हेन वी एक्सप्लोर द अर्थ क्रस्ट, वी सी दैट देयर आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ इंपॉर्टेंट मिनरल्स मिक्स्ड विद इंप्योरिटीज प्रेजेंट इन देयर. सो बट सी, व्हेन वी वांट, व्हेन वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस मिनरोलॉजी मिनरल्स. Because why we study minerals? Minerals because why minerals? Why we study minerals? Minerals because they are very very important for the economic value, for its economic value. And with minerals, we can develop so many things like aluminium. When we talk about aluminium, we can out of aluminium, we can make aluminium facades, aluminium utensils. When we talk about minerals derived from the rock, that is iron and steel, and you can just imagine how versatile the iron and steel is used, and it has an economic value, and how costly iron and steel is. So when we talk about the economic value, we can talk about the Gulf countries where the petroleum is available within the earth in that country, and they sell the petroleum, petrol and diesel, and so costly. and that brings economy to the Gulf region, to those countries. And once the country becomes rich, of course the standard of living of that population or the citizens also is increased, is raised. So they live a very comfortable life because they have more money, because they have minerals, the resources within their country. Our country is also rich in mineral resources. For example, in Jharkhand, when we talk about Jharkhand has a rich availability of coal and iron ore. We can say iron ore is also available somewhere in Odisha, Kyunjhar mines. So Kolar mines, we have gold available. So there are so many other mines where different minerals are available within our country. And once we tap the minerals, and we can utilize it for making so many useful products and services. So this is very, very important. And first of all, Dikhi, in order to understand mineralogy, let us try to understand basically, can we call all the rocks as a mineral? The rocks are available on the earth's crust, but can we call all the rocks as a mineral? No, all rocks cannot be called as a mineral. All rocks cannot be called as a mineral. So what are the conditions for a rock to be called a mineral? So four conditions are there for a substance to be called a mineral. They have a definite chemical formula. So chemical formula must exist. That is very, very important. Then it must occur naturally as an inorganic substance. So mineral, koi bhi substance ko mineral kehne ke liye, in order to identify a mineral, it must be having a chemical formula. It must have the inorganic substance. Must have orderly internal structure. Internal structure should be an orderly, and it should be in a well order. Physical, it should have fixed physical properties and composition of structure. So composition and physical property of structure should be fixed. Now when we talk about mineralogy, what are the different types of minerals? We can see that minerals are grouped into two types. And two types, out of which one is, we can say, one type is rock forming minerals and ore forming minerals. So when we talk about rock forming minerals, we can explain they are found in abundance in rocks. So rock forming minerals are found in abundance in the earth crust, and they are available within the rocks. Ore forming minerals. What is ore forming minerals? When we talk about ore forming minerals, they are those substances which are of economic value and do not occur in abundance in rocks. So ore forming mineral and rock forming minerals are the two categories in which minerals can be divided. And when we talk about these minerals, when we talk about rock forming minerals, they are found in abundance. For example, silica. So silica available in the form of sand, but sand has you can use sand in the form of construction, but they also have some little economic value that we can use in construction sand. But minerals, ore forming minerals are very, very important, and they are having, ore forming minerals have economic value, and they do not occur in abundance in the rock. So whatever rock that is available within the earth's crust, ore forming mineral is not available, it's very less quantity, and there are impurities available, and along with the impurities, the ore forming minerals are available. Ore forming minerals need to be extracted by various chemical and physical process in the industry, and they need to be processed. So ore forming minerals, for example, bauxite is the mineral from which aluminium can be extracted. So bauxite minerals are taken to the industry where the bauxite ore is processed and it passes through different processes in the industry. And finally, you know, aluminium is gained. Similarly, zinc is also coming from the ore, zinc ore. So इसमें जो ore होता है, that is iron ore. Iron ore is also there where from where we can extract iron. Zinc ore we can extract zinc. So copper ore, so these all these minerals in the form of metallic minerals, we can see that they come from the ore forming minerals. They are available in small quantities, that is why they are costly. Now when we talk about mineral groups, so what are the groups of minerals when we talk about that? So groups of minerals, we can say that what are the groups of minerals? So let us discuss groups of minerals. Now when we talk about groups of minerals, how many groups are there? So when we talk about groups of minerals, how many groups are there? So in this, the first group is we can say that is oxide. Oxide form the first group of minerals. The example is we can say quartz is an example of oxide group of minerals. We can say magnetite or hematite, where we find the iron ore. Hematite iron ore is obtained. So from these iron ore, they are available in the form of oxide. And next group of minerals, that is silicates. So when we talk about the silicates mineral, mica and feldspar, for example, are the example of silicate minerals. Now when we talk about the next group of minerals, they are available as carbonates. So minerals in the carbonate group, we can say minerals in the carbonate group, we can say that are available as calcite and dolomite. So calcite and dolomite minerals are available as carbonates in the carbonate group when we talk about that. Next, when we talk about the mineral group, that is sulfides. So sulfide group ka jo mineral hota hai, the pyrites and galena. When we talk about pyrites, the mineral pyrites and galena are available in the group of sulfides. Now when we talk about chlorides, so sulfates. अब सल्फेट्स जो मिनरल होता है, ये सल्फेट्स ग्रुप जो होता है, इसका जो एग्जांपल है दैट इज जिप्सम. सो दीज आर द एंड वन मोर मिनरल दैट इज अवेलेबल इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वी कैन से क्लोराइड्स. एंड व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट क्लोराइड्स, द एग्जांपल इज रॉक सॉल्ट. So rock salt is an example of chlorite group of minerals. So these are the groups of minerals when we talk about that occur in nature in the rocks. So this is about minerals and their groups and what are the types of minerals that are present. Now basically when we talk about minerals and we'll just in brief we can say that we'll try to discuss we can say that the structure, physical, one of the physical property we'll just try to discuss in today's lecture. And in today's lecture we'll just try to discuss the today we'll try to discuss the physical properties of minerals. Now to explain one of the physical properties. So one of the physical property we can explain is we'll just try to explain first of all physical properties. सो फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मिनरल्स, सो देर आर सो मेनी फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मिनरल्स दैट कैन बी वी कैन डिस्कस, आउट ऑफ विच लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द स्ट्रक्चर. सो द वेरी फर्स्ट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मिनरल इज स्ट्रक्चर. Structure of a mineral. So, structure of a mineral are of how many types? We can say how many types structure of a mineral are there. When we talk about the structure of the of a mineral may be of fibrous type. Fibrous type of minerals, mineral structure, and they are the example of fibrous type. They may be. They may have the fiber like strands. So asbestos is an example. Asbestos is an example of fibrous type of minerals which may occur in the form of fiber. Just in the sketch we can see that just how it looks like, that asbestos, all these fibers, you know, form the part of fibrous structure of the mineral. Now the next structure that may occur in the type of mineral is columnar structure. In the columnar structure, the columnar structure of minerals, an example is numerous coarse or fine grained packed together. Example is chromite. So chromite is an example of a mineral which is in the form of columnar structure. Or the columnar structure hota hai. तो न्यूमरस कोर्स और फाइन ग्रेन फाइन ग्रेन पैक्ड टुगेदर. अब ये जो फाइन ग्रेन जो पैक्ड टुगेदर होता है वो कॉलमनर शेप में होता है, दैट इज कॉलमनर स्ट्रक्चर. सो नेक्स्ट वी कैन टॉक अबाउट इज वी कैन टॉक अबाउट नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर दैट मे बी ग्रैनुलर. अब ग्रैनुलर स्ट्रक्चर जो मिनरल्स में होते हैं, ग्रैनुलर स्ट्रक्चर इज अवेलेबल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कोर्स और फाइन ग्रेन पैक्ड टुगेदर. एग्जांपल इज क्रोमाइट. यस, सो ग्रैनुलर कॉलमनर स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉलमनर स्ट्रक्चर वी हैव जस्ट डिस्कस्ड. एंड आई एम सॉरी, द कॉलमनर स्ट्रक्चर इज नॉट क्रोमाइट. कॉलमनर स्ट्रक्चर इज hot blend. Let us write it as a horn blend, and granular structure is chromite. So horn blend is the example of columnar structure of minerals, and granular structure is example is chromite. So chromite is an example of granular structure. Next structure that comes in the physical property of mineral, that is acicular, we can say foliated structure. So minerals having foliated structure, they are thin separate sheets. They can be made into thin separate sheets. Example is mica. तो फॉलिएटेड स्ट्रक्चर जो का जो मिनरल का एग्जांपल है दैट इज माइका. एंड देन एसिकुलर, देन अनदर स्ट्रक्चर इज एसिकुलर, ACICULAR. एसिकुलर द एग्जांपल इज इट इज अवेलेबल इन थिन शार्प और फाइन नीडल. एन एग्जांपल इज नेट्रोलाइट. सो नेट्रोलाइट इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ यू नो दिस एसिकुलर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द मिनरल्स. And then we can say bladed structure. So bladed structure, when we talk about bladed structure, the example is blade-like structure as it has. An example is kyanite, K-Y-A-N-I-T-E. So the kyanite mineral has a bladed structure. And then when we talk about this tabular structure. When we talk about tabular structure of minerals, it has broad flat surface. Like example is feldspar. So feldspar has a tabular structure of minerals. And then the last but not least the structure of minerals, that is reniform. Reniform structure of minerals, the common example, it has kidney shape beans, and hematite is the example of reniform structure. We can say that hematite is an example of this structure. Now here we discuss one of the physical property of a mineral, that is a structure. So structure of a mineral is very, very important. And another most important, I can say, you know, physical property of mineral that we can say is, although there are so many other property, physical properties, but we can say that the next physical property of mineral, I erase the board and then we move on to the next physical property of mineral. So next physical property of mineral is the crystal system. So let us talk about crystal system of the minerals. So regarding let us talk about the next physical property of minerals, and that is crystal system. Physical property of minerals, and here we will discuss the second property, and that is crystal system. Crystal system, we will just try to explain and understand how many types of crystal systems are available. So rectangular polyhedral form bounded by smooth surface acquired under action of intermolecular forces. So crystal system is rectangular polyhedral form. Rectangular polyhedral form, it is a part of the crystal system. So when we talk about the crystal system of a mineral, we can say that there are so many other crystal systems. The first crystal system is cubic. This is in the form, we can just, I will just draw a diagram of cubic form. Cubic basically is just like a cube. So iska jo crystals hota hai, it is just like that in the form of a cube. The crystals of the crystal structure of the mineral is a cubic form. So cubic basically is isometric. So it is isometric. So cubic form is isometric. So cubic crystal is the is isometric, you can see isometric, and it has three equal axes at right angles to each other. Example is fluorite. Fluorite is a very common example of this isometric cubic crystal system. The next crystal system is tetragonal system. Tetragonal system. Here in tetragonal system, basically the shape is just like a cube, but basically three axes at right angles, two equal, and third one is longer. So isme kya the in a tetragonal system, basically the structure is just like that, but iska jo ek axis hai, one of the axis is longer than the other one. So this is called tetragonal system of crystals, and here the example is zircon. Example of minerals is zircon. So zircon minerals is an example of tetragonal system. And now when we talk about the next crystal system, crystal structure of the mineral, and that is hexagonal system. So hexagonal crystals kiske hote hain in a mineral. So when we talk about hexagonal this crystal system, so hexagonal crystal system is just like we can just say that it is just like this. We draw a hexagon, or iska crystal jo hota hai hexagon ke form mein matlab hota hai. So 1 1 2 3 4 5 6, and just like this, ye इसका जो क्रिस्टल्स होते हैं जस्ट लाइक दिस इट इज फॉर्म, ये हेक्सागन की तरह होता है और हेक्सागोनल सिस्टम इसमें देर आर फोर एक्सेस, थ्री इक्वल एट 60 डिग्री, वर्टिकल लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट, एंड एग्जाम्पल इज क्वार्ट्ज. सो क्वार्ट्ज इज अ सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ हेक्सागोनल क्रिस्टल सिस्टम. देन वी टॉक अबाउट हेक्सागोनल क्रिस्टल सिस्टम इज देयर, देन ऑर्थोरॉम्बिक सिस्टम. ऑर्थोरॉम्बिक, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट ऑर्थोरॉम्बिक सिस्टम, when we talk about orthorhombic system, we'll just try to explain. So this, let us try to write on the topic, that is physical property of minerals, and we are discussing crystal system. So there are a few crystal system and their example that we can just discuss. So crystal system we were just discussing, and let us see, talk about the next crystal system, that is orthorhombic. So we have discussed A, B, C, and we'll discuss now the fourth one, that is orthorhombic. So orthorhombic crystal system basically is something like this, where I draw the sketch. The see, the top surface is just like it is in the form of a rhombus, where the you can say they are not at right angle, but they are at certain angle, and this is orthorhombic crystal system. So orthorhombic crystal system, three axis is at differential different length, intersect at right angle. So when they intersect this is at right angle, we can say. So for this example, orthorhombic system is, the example is topaz. Topaz is a very good example of orthorhombic crystal system. And then we can say that the next crystal system, that is monoclinic crystal system. So when we talk about monoclinic crystal system, monoclinic crystal system is something, three unequal axis, one horizontal axis at right angle, two vertical axis, and third is inclined. So that is a monoclinic crystal system. So three unequal axis, one horizontal, and at right angle to the vertical axis. So ये monoclinic crystal system जो बनता है, इट इज समथिंग लाइक दैट, जो कि बिल्कुल ही अनइक्वल है, मतलब जिसके एक्सिस की जो लेंथ है वो बिल्कुल ही अनइक्वल है. और ये समथिंग इट वर्क्स लाइक समथिंग दिस टाइप, वेयर द एवरीथिंग इज इन डिफरेंट शेप, ये बिल्कुल ही अनइक्वल शेप में होता है. तो इसमें जनरली जो होता है, इट इज दे आर नॉट एट एंगल्स, एंड वी कैन सी दैट दिस इज मोनोक्लिनिक सिस्टम ऑफ क्रिस्टल सिस्टम ऑफ मिनरल्स. An example of monoclinic crystal system is gypsum. We can say that this is gypsum. So gypsum is an example of monoclinic crystal system. And the next, then the last one that is come in the crystal system, that is triclinic system. So triclinic system of crystals, the crystals of triclinic system, we can say it has three unequal axes, none at right angle. तीन अनइक्वल एक्सिस होता है, नॉन एट राइट एंगल, दैट इज ट्राइक्लिनिक सिस्टम. तो नॉन आर एट राइट एंगल, कोई भी राइट एंगल में नहीं होता है इसके सिस्टम. तो ये जो है समथिंग लाइक दिस. तो दिस इज द ट्राइक्लिनिक सिस्टम ऑफ मिनरल्स. यू कैन से नॉन ऑफ द एक्सिस इज एट राइट एंगल, समथिंग लाइक. सो यह ट्राइक्लिनिक सिस्टम, द एग्जाम्पल इज एक्सीलाइट. So axinite is an example of triclinic system. So this was the course on the mineralogy that we covered in R, C, E, 071, geology and soil mechanics.
So this is the subject where we have covered one of the topic as per AKTU syllabus, as per AKTU syllabus. So thanks all of you for this lecture.